This is Mission Control Houston, looking at the Space Station Flight Control Room at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, where a team of flight controllers are on duty helping the Expedition 30 crew through a day focused on science and maintenance on board the International Space Station. Flight engineers Andre Kalpers and Don Pettit began their day with some tests of their reaction time in order to monitor the effects of fatigue, while flight engineers Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin measured their body masses and observed for distribution of fluids. Later on in the day, Pettit did the VO2 max experiment, which is measuring his oxygen uptake during exercise. All of those are part of the ongoing human life sciences research to find out how prolonged exposure to microgravity impacts the human body. Other science work done today included taking measurements of the amount of methane and carbon dioxide in the Earth's atmosphere. Flight engineer Oleg Kononenko was at the controls for that Russian experiment. Later in the day, he also took some microbial air samplings of the atmosphere inside the space station. For Commander Dan Burbank, a good portion of his day was spent in the Quest airlock, where he was setting up and then executing a protocol to scrub the cooling loops of two of the spacesuits, the EMUs, or extravehicular mobility units. The spacesuits that are worn for spacewalks that are conducted on the U.S. section of the space station. Those spacesuits have cooling systems in order to keep the astronauts inside them at a comfortable temperature. And during the times when the suits are not used over an extended period of time, they require some maintenance to make sure that the loops remain clear of any debris. All of the crew members had time during the day-to-day, at some part, to take part in daily cleaning activities and also regular maintenance of the station. Burbank, Kalpers, and Pettit spent some time just after their lunch today discussing the mission in an interview with the Weather Channel. And late in the day, Burbank and Kalpers performed routine eye examinations that are part of an ongoing effort to learn more about how human bodies respond and change during long stretches of time away from gravity. On Thursday morning, the team in Mission Control began planning for the possible debris avoidance maneuver, which, if necessary, was scheduled to take place on Friday morning. The trajectory operations officers are watching a piece of debris from the Iridium 33 communications satellite that might pass close by the station on two consecutive orbits on Friday afternoon. Due to some unusual drag conditions and solar activity and atmospheric density, the teams are developing a debris avoidance maneuver plan as a precaution. If that maneuver is necessary, it would be executed sometime on a Friday morning at approximately 10:20 a.m. Central Time. Also on the schedule for the crew on Friday, Kalpers has a ham radio opportunity to talk to students in Belgium. Crew members will continue preparing the Progress ship for departure later this month while continuing to work to keep their home on orbit humming smoothly along.